Okay. So at this point, what do I have? Mesh loading, mesh imported, mesh renders. All right. Yes. Even if the rendering order is a bit off. Looks a bit weird. Ah, whatever. Anyways, so at this point, there's mesh, bones, the skeleton or the armature, and the animations to import. So, first things first, I'm going to import the mesh vertex bone weights. Bone weights, of course, tell which vertex, which bones to follow, and by how much percentage, I suppose. Typically, there's up to four, but there can be more or there can be less. the first thing to do really is to figure out how the maximum. Okay, if we're not setting the number of max bone weights that there are, we should be able to query how many there are at maximum and then to determine the number, perhaps. So, we'll get like int. Maybe there's two I can actually go about with this, actually, I'm thinking. Have a vector that shows how many there are, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the percentage that there are, and then we can have another function derived from that that just says the maximum or the most popular. But all the options are there. That as an auto, of course. Put that as a tuple. So we have int. First of all, we need to determine the weights per vertex. Since, unfortunately, as it doesn't import them per vertex, they import it per bone. So each bone has a bunch of weights and vertexes. So we gotta kind of transform that into the other form so I can actually figure out how many weights there are per vertex. Unfortunate, but this is something that you wouldn't really pro you'd only process like once when importing it, rather than something you would import every time. Well, something you would import once and then re-export in like a more binary format rather than something that would be loaded expensively like this every single time from the raw, FBX and Clutter files. Vertices. There'll be zeros. Each bone. Bone. Oh my god. I cannot spell today. Okay, no, int and int rather than a percentage, just the number of weight, the number of weights times the number of vertices. So you can do like a calculation based on like size, number versus size, memory versus whatever, rather than having a kind of vague percentage. Makes a bit more sense. M weights. Have them all, then we'll go through and I think like a namespace kind of thing. Probably. Yeah, we'll figure out in a second. Oh, we don't even need that. We just need like an int. 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on and so forth. So just a vector of int. Yeah, that makes sense. Weight per bone. If vertices by weight dot size. Size to plus one and then increment well I really cannot type today that then we can return that okay. Run that, see what we get out of it. Down here. No, not here. Down here. So in this case, I think they'll all be pretty even. Yeah, it's just straight up number two. There's two. Vertices per all the vertices. Two weights per vertex, all of them, straight up. In this case. I'll try. Hold on. Let's see if I can have a more interesting model to have a look at. Okay. I think I found one. Do, 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 do. See what we've got going on here. There we go, a bit more of a mixture. Up to 9. That's, yeah. So, considering the major fall off would be like 4 or 5. Maybe 6. Probably 4, though. I'd probably want to just, whoop, merge the weights that are above this level down to just the original 5. Actually, that's 5. That'd be 4. Well, actually, no, there's none with none. So yeah, it is, it would actually be 1 through 4, be the most popular. Okay, now that I know that, let's do the next one in the line, which would be what, get max. Basically be similar. Or we just return an int, which is just the, you know, that's short enough, just that. You know what? Actually, we'll just make this a public function. Get vertices, get weights per vertex. No, we'll just keep this namespace. Where it just does this portion. Again, I don't mind if it's going to be a bit expensive at this point. Okay, same thing here. Get the maximum of all these. So we got all of them. We just go through 4. In that value. Okay. You know what, just try to keep it consistent. Okay, so we got max. Okay. At this point, we'll do what we have. We have mesh vertices by weight, or the max per vertex weight. So at this point, what you would know is the number of weights you want to do per vertex to import with. So then it'd be a thing, a void import mesh text bone weights, bone weight data. Magic. Now, per vertex bone data weight, gonna need like a little float, so the weight and the bone for that weight. Of course, this is on a per mesh basis, not on a per model basis. Okay. Weights. We'll construct it from the weight. Now, there may be more weights per vertex right now than we want, than what we limited it to. So we need to grab them all through this first portion. Then we want to, like, if we have to collapse them or merge them down to the desired maximum limit, because it should all, as long as it's greater than zero, that is, it should all equal one. Otherwise, you'll have a very strange. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I need to collapse it. At least that's what I think. I need like a little function for this as well, don't I? Take in a vertex bone weight set. Actually, no. We just make a copy of it at the start, then we could just. We already have a copy, we just work on that. So. I'll figure out which way it sorts in a moment. No, but if it's less than or equal to, so it's. We'll just return it. The weights to the left, we're going to have to rework them to one, so. Multiply by that to renormalize to one, and then return that instead. Okay. Then we'll have to write the data out. Okay. Oh, crap. Add the microphone again. Okay. What I need to do is, okay, you went. So what we need is like a you went. Can I if I just do like an unsigned char, does that work? No, okay. So we'll have two things. We'll have uint 32. Actually, rather. Need to reinterpret. And then it'll be a float for the weight. Is it index, indices, and then weights. Plus what? It's a per byte basis, so size of hat times per max per vertex weights. Written equals 0. Collapsed weights we have, we just go ahead and write them. It's not the first, it's the second. Then while written less than x per vertex weights. We just set these to 0. Advance the bytes for the next one. Okay. Let's get a large. Let's do two. We'll get a large buffer. Times, let's see, how many bytes do we need? We need the number of. Num vertices. Times size of foot plus size of un 32 times. Vertices by weight to start off with. Or max. Or dot size, actually. Right? Would it be size minus one? Okay, you know what? No. Really? Oh, I didn't save it. Okay, that. Then we'll actually go through the process of. Oh, I didn't actually add this. Mesh, max weights per vertex, capital P, with the data weight, data dot data, or dot get actually. Okay, let's see. If I'm at the max, that means I should never actually have to go through the process of collapsing. So let's see if it ever reaches this. And we'll see if the address sanitizer decides to scream that I overran a buffer or something. Ooh, what the hell is this? Oh, yeah, okay. This is the other. That's because this is the other one. But it didn't actually hit, so that's good. So let's see if we can collapse down to four. We'll keep that. We'll just hit this down to four. And we'll see how the weights go. The merging weights go. Excellent. So what we have 5 weights. Okay, one, I think it's the wrong way around. So it's incrementing instead of decrementing. So that's wrong. I need to do it the opposite way. Let's see what we can. Standard sort. It's part of algorithm, first of all, so I'm going to need to include algorithm. Algorithm. Okay, no, that's right. Stop it. Sort. Find, copy, generate, remove, da, 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 reverse. No. Lower, upper, difference, whole bunch of stuff on ranges. Is there no like decrementing? All right, I'll need my own. Okay, I'll need my own sorting. Lambda. Let's see. Da, da, da. Auto A, auto B. That'll be it. Then we go through. Turn standard get of 0 greater than. A is greater than 1 of B. Okay. The weight is the first thing, right? Yeah. Okay, let's see if the weights are right. 0. Okay, here we go. This looks much better. It's 0.8, 0. Wait, no. That's all screwed up. That sorting mechanism did nothing. Really? Did it do anything? Oh, crap. Comparing the different types. Whoops, diddly doodly. Lot better. 0.5, 0.11080664. Okay. With different bone indices. Okay. So let's see. Total weights basically comes out to almost one. 0.86, so multiplier becomes what? That. 0.56. 6.5. Da, 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 da. 0.12. Ten, 12 turns into 117. 0.8 turns to 0.09. Okay, looks pretty okay. Let's see if we do this again. Just make sure. That's as close as we're going to get. It's a lot better than what it was started off with, which was what? So we got like what? 9.5. Okay, that was wrong. 9.8. Come on. 9.4. 2.99, yeah. Renormalize as much as close as we can get. I wonder if doing it by float will be better. Since they are floats, increasing the precision isn't going to help. You got to keep it at the same precision or less. First one was really the biggest one. Difference. Eight, six to one. 9.5 to one. 9.8 to one. Yeah, basically. Okay. So that collapses them down. Collapse them weights down. We get the data. Okay, so now we have the data here. Now, how do I want to mix this data in the data binding and attributes and that. Okay, we got the weight data. This is pretty close. Even though, like, yeah. Okay. What we're going to do is we're going to put it in with the mesh vertex data. Do we want a separate vertex buffer? I mean, that would allow for loading it in separately, but why would you want to do that? You might just always want to have it on hand in the GPU for use, like always. Okay. We'll set it to 4. 4 now, always. We have 4 UN32s and 4 floats. That'll allow it in the shader just to be like a UVEC 4 and a VEC 4. Just nice and simple. One shader for all. Later on, we can kind of start mixing and matching them with like 2s and 1s and whatevers. But in the moment, in the meantime, we get the weight data, we get all this. So we kind of take this out and say, we'll say it's always that, it's always 4. increment. We allocate buffers with plus that. Bit larger right now, that makes sense. Let's switch back to the animated cube. We allocate, we map the buffers, we have the data. Then we mem copy the extra data, so p vertex data plus this. From weight data dot get for size of this, interpret cast int t. Increment it by that much. Copy all that in. Same thing for the rest of it. We copy it in, we upload the data. So first half the buffers. Mesh data, the second half is the weight fit data. Because we may want to, not every model will be animated or have bones active. So there's no real point in interleaving it. In my opinion, my idea for the moment. Keep it separate. So this should actually have no effect on the visual representation of the cube right now. Except for this, that. Okay. Very interesting. Okay, but the cube is cube. Okay, so I now have that data in the GPU. I'm just trying to think of how to, because of course I need to figure out the per mesh, like armature. I need to load in the armature. I need to load in the bones themselves and then the animation data to manipulate them in the shader. I mean, I have the raw animation bone weights and the indices in the GPU now. I just can't, I can put them, okay. Actually, for the moment, I can bring them into the shader if I just have them always times the identity matrix, I suppose. Oh, that's pointless. Or is it? As long as they're always at 1 times 1. Yeah, we can do that. Let's actually make a copy. Boned. Mesh boned. Okay. So 0, 1, 2, so I believe 3 and 4, and they're always right now. Okay. It's 3 in vec, sorry, uvec 4, because it was the indices are first. In bone ID. Bone weights indices. The imposition, yeah. Still a model, and that is times one times just that. Good on that. Okay, so out UV stuff. We're going to have a matrix mat 4. Bone trans. At 4 of 0, go through 4 and 0, less than 4, plus I, bone transform, bone. I don't have bones yet, actually. Identity times in bone weights of I. I'm really hoping that turns into the identity matrix. Don't know if it does. But all things go well. So we'll do that, and would it be projection view? No, it'd be part. It'd be here in the middle. Position times the bone transforms times projection view. Make sure that actually does it build? It does build. Okay, good. Mesh bone. What we have is we have another per. Is a stride of basically the same thing. Okay, it's not doing that anymore. Let's there we go. Clang just stops, quits working after a while for whatever reason. Dot input binding rate. Okay. So this doesn't really matter, but we have, what, 8? So 4 times size of float times size of UM32T binding of 1, location binding of 1. Is that up? 4 times both of those, okay. Then we have another 2 of these guys. 3 and 4. 3 is a format of B32U int. Offset of 0. And 4 times U32T. But it's an S float. Location 4, and it's using binding 2, oh sorry, 1, not 0. Binding 0, binding 1. Okay. See how this, what does this look like right now? It looks terrifying, right? Looks broken. Come on. Show me I'm wrong. I am wrong. Great. How am I wrong? Oh, yes. Plus. Not 4 by 4. 4 plus 4 times 4. Still wrong. Whoop, whoop. Whoop. I'm not binding the other vertex stuff. Yeah, I'm not binding it. Bind, 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 bind that one. Okay, we have a buffer. Okay. Then we bind the same thing. But it's at offset. First binding of one. Start of one. We do the first one as it is. Then we, whoops, down one. Okay, up, up. Where was I? Down, 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 down. Set the offsets. Which is massive. I need the value of this. Vertex data offset equals. This. And then we set it down here. Vertex buffer, offset of that on position one or binding one. Okay, not great. Break out the render dock. Viewer on color past that, the first one. Here we go. So we do have a cube. So what's going on is in position in UV, in bone indices. Whoa! Okay, first of all, this screwed up. That's not great. See, these are just way off. This is garbage data, obviously. Man, that's not very good. Okay. In bone indices and stuff. So what I need is vertex buffers, command buffers. So we're binding 177, right? Yes. First binding and binding of that P buffer, that buffer. at that offset of 1152, which is what? 36 by 8 by 4. Buffer 196. Let's view the contents. So what have we got? What have we got? We got a lot of stuff, actually. Dang, yeah, that's a bit off, awkward. Okay. Yeah. How the hell am I supposed to be able to read this? Vec4. Okay. Goes down to about 36, and then we get some really wonky data from there. Okay. Let's see. Maybe, first of all, I'm not bringing the data in very well. Let's have a look at this. Because the index is second. Oh, then, yeah. And then two, three, and four. And then we leave. We're out of here. We increment that. Okay, can I do like a reinterpret? Actually, yeah. 32T of P bytes. So right now, converts to what? What? Star of P bytes. It's now a zero. One. Crazy data. It's one. Okay. Three. Oh yeah, that'd be, yeah. NP weight. Yeah. Yeah. Very small. Wait, zero and one point very small. I'm sorry, what? What's with the weights here? Sorry. Zero point 85 and 0.14. Oh, course. 4. There we go. 4, 5, 6, and 7. They are right. Okay. No address sanitizer. Let's get out of here. What is the vertex weight data size? 1152. So what? We got 8. Yeah, same thing as the thing. We have another 8 by 4 plus 4 times 36. Okay. Okay. What if, what if I was to separate it as a separate buffer, but on the same device memory? I could maybe read it a bit easier. 8. No. No. Yeah, because they are 8x8. So if I do like uvec4 by vec4, apply, and on 36 they should change over to absolutely garbage. Yeah, terrible. Okay, so I am uploading the data wrong, or I'm not uploading the right data. Okay, P vertex data is what that. Plus that times that. Okay, no, I can't actually work with this. Calculator. K-calc. Where are you? Where did you pop up? Oh, there you are. So we got numlock 36 by, what, 8? 288. So what we want is a reinterpret cast. Okay. It's still zero, really, really. Oh no, it'd be zero. Maybe. Okay. For and float. Sorry, not 4, 5. 6 and 7. Okay, what's going on? Did I just not? I copied the data in. Oh, the recording of the data! You dumbass. I didn't actually. Yes. As part of the Vertex data size, I didn't actually add that to be copied in onto the GPU. I mean, not that it helped at all. Seemingly. Let's bring this back over. Relaunch. No. Give it a go. Let's see what happens. What's going on? What is going on? Mesh viewer for that one. Yeah. No. What? What? Zero, 1, 2, 3. And then I presume 4, 5, 6, 7. Uh-huh. What? It's just like the incrementing value? What? This is definitely not the data I was putting in. Okay, see, here it looks... Okay, down here it's fine, at this point. But for this first one, it's not. Like, these look pretty okay. These ones definitely are not. What's going on with this first set? But all the data that was passed in was just bad. Like I UVec4 and VEC4 location 3 and 4 with binding of 1 which has a very similar stride size. If not the same. Thirty-two, but binding location 1. Input rate of per vertex, yes.
0. U132 float. Binding 1, binding 1, location 3 and 4. Offset 0, offset of 16. Okay. Is vertex data size time size of float wrong? Like this is what? I incremented by 1152 bytes. And then I put it in by 1152. Size of the buffer I'm allocating is correct. Vertex data size 2304. Should be like what? But the vert, okay. I copy the weight data in. That's great. The weight data. Data is correct. So then, okay. P vertex data. Was it It is properly enmeshed in there. The right locations and everything. So then, where am I getting this random stuff? It's randomly incrementing number. Because .288 is right. Right? I go float, so 8 times 36. What? 8 floats times 36 equals 304. Wait, what am I? Divided by what? 4 bytes. 288 bytes. Huh? Am I just exhausted? What? Where did I get this 304 number from? Is there like a history? Nope. Okay. Okay. Got a drink. Get a drink. Okay. Let's try it. Let's rerun the render doc. Let's just to make sure this is the latest, right? Yeah, okay. To load this first. Color pass, we got that. Index, vertex buffer. Is it 177? Okay, it's 177 this time. Command buffer. What is with this? Okay, up to 36. That's great. Then you get. What is with this extra? Okay. Mesh view is just. It's just nothing. The vertex items in. Vertex stuff out. Okay. Close that up, close this up, go that. Actually, now we have nothing. Really? That's actually rather interesting. Why? Where did the cube go? Why? Did I muck? Okay. Maybe I have to backtrack a bit.
Sorry, what? What? Vertex buffer. This buffer. That's just this one. Starting at binding with an offset of 0. 96. 196. View contents. Vec 3 and vec 2. As it just goes variations between negative 1 and 1. Down to 36. Then we get a bunch of other stuff. Before then, it kind of resets. Up to 35, really. Animated. Okay. Let's back up a bunch then. Back. Keep going. Really far back. We're talking real. Oh, that's as far back as we're going. Dang it. Animated cube. We're still on mesh boned. Okay, that's not good. Okay, we're back at the cube. Great. Okay, let's save what we have. We have vertex component, we have engine, we have that. We have this, we have pipeline pool, which with vertex shader. Got SIMP. Got the animated cube. Okay, we have this as a baseline. Now let's move forward again. We want to do this mesh bound binding location 1, 8 or 4 times size of float. Plus the size of that. RGB32A32 it starts at 4 times. Okay, that starts at 0. Size of that. For the moment, maybe it's because I'm screwing this up. Maybe what if I just like this raw data, don't care about any of this, it's not used. It's good. I mean, we have a bunch of stuff. I didn't set the other. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, one thing we need is we need to set the other vertex buffer. There you are. Start at one, we got that. Same vertex buffer. Offset location that. It's need to bring that back. Float. So we're allocating that plus that. I'm going to map the buffers. We're then going to mem copy in. Starting at not vertex weight data size, text data size. Make sure I'm not screwing this up yet. Okay. So all a cube. Yeah, nothing going crazy yet. And if I was to bring it up in render doc, it's going to still look like a cube for the mesh data. You. Yes, you are still a cube. Yeah, it's all on the outside. Very strange looking, actually. Do a fly cam? Oh, okay, I see. Oh, I can actually select with a right mouse button. Okay. Anyways, mesh is great. Fantastic. If I go look at the vertex buffer. For 196, as usual, view contents, vec 3, and then vec 2. It's all good, out down to 35. Do, 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 bam. And then it's 0. So I copied nothing in. Okay, that's good. I'm copying nothing in. Because here, it's vertex buffer, so it's vertex data size. Plus vertex weight data size. Ooh. This is track. I remember this from somewhere else. Have here. I know this from somewhere else. Chocolate? What was it? What is it? The compilation album. Whatever. I'll figure it out another day. Okay. Uploading data. Nothing. Why? What is okay? Why? I'm not even using the data yet. It has no bearing. It's just in position, being passed through. It means nothing. Okay, what if I just... It literally does nothing. Like, not even an accidentally going out... It's out of memory to try to find this stuff? And then it just craps out? Maybe. Wait, data size? Okay. I mean, I'm still not getting sanitizer issues. Why? Here's a wand with a silencer on it. Why? Can I ask why? Can we do this? We have resources, buffer 196. So when I care about view contents, we got vec3, and a vec2. Okay, that's great. This is the same stuff at the 35, and then it does this, and then that. I do have... What if I try the memory sanitizer? Oh, I should configure and generate it first, then build it. Come on. Okay, this is... I don't know where the hell this is. Sorry? What? Oh, this is inside this... It's inside GLFW, like... This is beyond my... Oh, okay. No. Going back to address. Somehow, me just adding those other things to be copied in results in, just bad stuff. Oh, I see it now, I think. Because I'm mapping index data where the... Vertex weight data would be. Okay. Yeah, see, this is super suspect. We do this. So I was just overriding the index data, or the index data was being... Oh, that's why they were incrementing. It was the index data. 36 uints of index data, which just plain old increment of 0 to 35. Oh my god. I can't believe I missed. Wasted like half an hour on that. Fantastic. Fantastic. Okay. Okay. We got that. It was board data aliasing on my part. In pointer management. Well, pointer management? Poor memory management. Well, not even that, really. Okay, so we got this. The other data. We can probably bring this stuff back in. That. And that's why it was appearing as nothing, because all the indices were basically zero instead. It was copying it from the wrong location. And then the index table has begun. Oh, this is just bad. Well, no, the index data would have been right. It would just been right. Maybe. Whatever. Okay, we got that. It's meshed data. Times about like 0.5 or something like that. Really weird. Like shrink it by half. I guess this has literally no effect. Of course it doesn't. I'm not even using the matrix yet. What? Interesting. What am I looking at? I don't understand what I'm looking at. Very strange. Okay, let's do another uniform. Crap. Equals what? What is it? It's like one and the binding one and two. Set one equals one. Armature UBO. What is this? Like a maximum of let's just define. It's like 64 for the moment. So it'd be like this times. And this would probably be some kind of definable value. Something like that. Yeah, right now I have the camera UBO, right? Which is done through this descriptor pool, which is rebuilt every frame pretty expensively. All right. Well, okay, hold on. Maybe before jumping into this. Let's instead just do this. Get the weird one coming in. That's fantastic. That's fine. Check render doc. See if like the data is as expected. Maybe it's just because I don't know my math from my English or similar. F12, great. We got information coming out. Check it. The mesh viewer. The data going in is still a cube that leaves. Okay, the bone indices and in-bone weights are still absolutely screwed up. So I can still work on that. It's great. That's good, in a way. Not really. Starting at 35. Uh-huh. Okay, this is right. What's in the comp buffer is right. I just don't have it coming out properly. So, what's it? You in 1152 and buffer 196. Should ensure that the inbound indices and inbound weights. See, there's no 0.85s or whatever in here whatsoever. Oh, okay. It's not too bad. I don't I'm doing nonsense. Wait, what? Where on? Oh, no, this makes sense, because this is, yeah, 3D optimized, changed. The 0.84 is a bit of weird, but, okay. This, however, does not. This makes absolutely no sense. Location 3, location 4, UVEC 4 to VEC 4. Vertex data size becomes this. The offset is that.
Binding zero.
Fucking binding zero. No. No, 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 no. Wrong binding. That's... might explain. Might. Looks good. Let's just double check what it looks like here. Okay, vec4, and vec4, buffer is great, it's built correctly, 0s to 1s, 0 to 85s, yep, so back here, mesh view, great, in UV, whatever, inbone indices, inbone weights are correct, all the way through, just about, okay. Okay, it's no, but yes, and yes, we got a new good baseline to work off of now. The armature and the model UBO. Okay, how am I going to figure these ones out? Actually, no, I can call it here. I have mesh bone data for the vertex bone data imported. So I'll call it good on that one. I've already spent enough time on this, nearly 2 hours. The next one, I'll figure out how to import either import the bone animation data, skeletal bone animation data, or how to figure out how to organize this. I'll probably do the animation importation though. Cheers.